Ascent Audio, a division of Recorded Books, presents Strikingly Different Selling, 6 Vital Skills to Stand Out and Sell More, by Del Merrill, Scott Savage, Jennifer Colosimo, and Randy Illig. Narrated by Scott Savage, Jennifer Colosimo, Del Merrill, and Randy Illig. Publisher's note: this audiobook has bonus material. Please contact whomever you purchase this audiobook from to request the material.
Introduction. Become strikingly different online and in person. Mark was facing a daunting challenge. As a managing director at a global professional services company, he was proposing on a huge technology outsourcing deal. The client viewed the requested services as a commodity, i.e., anyone could provide them. The competitors were 3 strong companies that competed solely on price, and Mark's company was at the higher end of price and value. He needed a way to stand out and create contrast between his company and the competition, or he would have no chance to win. We met Mark in Bangalore, India, 2 months before the proposal was due, and coached him on the formula and skills of strikingly different selling. Mark embraced everything we shared and completely changed his approach to the pursuit. 2 months later, Mark and his team were awarded a $16 million contract, along with praise from the client that his team's proposal stood out as crisp, different, and compelling. After the win, Mark told us that to stand out, he looked at everything his team was planning to say and do in the proposal through the lens of strikingly different selling. Is this relevant? Focusing on what matters most to the client. Distinct, showing something different and better than the competition or status quo. And memorable, easy to share and hard to forget. And according to Mark, the formula and skills made all the difference in the win. This book is about how to stand out and sell more. It's about becoming strikingly different. When something is strikingly different, it is clearly different and better than its comparison. The overwhelming evidence shows that the inability of salespeople to stand out is a pervasive issue with costly consequences. Working with sales research firm Primary Intelligence, we analyzed the results of surveys with more than 5,000 business-to-business decision makers on deals. We found that average win rates were a dismal 17% for deals above $100,000 across multiple industries globally. What's going wrong? Until now, there have been lots of questions and rarely any helpful answers. Certainly, the sales environment has only intensified in the past decade. COVID massively accelerated the tectonic shift from live to virtual, i.e., live online, selling. A recent Bain survey found that 80% of buyers and sellers believe there will be a sustained increase in virtual interactions. In other words, virtual selling is here to stay. In the live online world, the classic techniques of selling are much less effective, sales pipelines are languishing, and the look and feel of buyer-seller interactions is very different. It's harder and harder for buyers to tell the difference between one salesperson's offerings and another's. Everyone looks and sounds the same. Competition is intense. As a result, many salespeople are having a hard time getting first meetings, are conducting plenty of additional meetings that go nowhere, and are simply not winning enough business. How can sellers stand out? The primary question today is, how can sellers stand out as different and better when the competition is at such a high level? While the challenges of standing out are intensified in the live online world, they are similar to the challenges of standing out in person. And the 4 of us authors know firsthand how difficult it is to stand out. We've tried, failed, and succeeded in numerous settings. Each of us has personally hit and missed sales targets, mastered the online sales environment, and led teams in the pursuit of greatness. As sales thought leaders and practitioners at the global performance improvement company Franklin Covey, we advise salespeople representing many of the top technology, consulting, and professional services organizations across the globe. In the course of our work, we've discovered three frustrating struggles most salespeople seem to have in common when it comes to standing out. 1. How can I come up with differentiated messages for my clients? 2. How do I pull the messages together into a cohesive set of stories? 3. How will I share these stories with clients in a compelling way? Through deal advancement work sessions, opportunity reviews, and other sales activities, we've helped thousands of salespeople overcome these struggles and gain confidence in their ability to craft, shape, and deliver compelling messages that enable them to stand out from the start to the finish of their sales cycles. In addition to our frontline experience and ongoing advisory work, we had a unique opportunity to get feedback from client executives on what matters most to them when talking with salespeople. This came about when several global companies engaged us to participate in live sales simulations over a period of 6 years. As part of these engagements, we saw both sides of nearly 1,700 sales interactions where we had front row seats as silent observers. This was fascinating work because we watched more than 2,800 experienced salespeople in sales meetings with senior client executives all along the sales cycle. We attended the meetings as observers, then interviewed the salespeople and client executives afterwards. It was an incredible opportunity to speak candidly to the selling team and the client. The salespeople we observed were highly paid and talented professionals. They were exceptionally educated and had long resumes. We expected greatness, solid selling fundamentals, market-leading expertise, and remarkable people skills. And as we interviewed the salespeople after each interaction, we heard the following common responses. I think the meeting went well. It wasn't perfect, but we felt there was good interaction and we definitely got what we needed. That was a solid meeting. I think we did a good job asking questions and exploring their business challenges. The client executive seems to like us and clearly wants to engage in further discussions. They love our solution, our implementation plan, and how clearly different we are from our competitors. We are in a great position to win this opportunity. But then we spoke with the client executives. Well over 70% of the time, the response from the client executive was some version of this. That meeting was a waste of my time, and in a real pursuit, they would not be invited back. How was it possible that all these talented salespeople could be so far off the mark? How could so many of them think they were doing a great job while disappointing the client over and over again? What was more intriguing is that after observing nearly 1,700 interactions, it became clear that we were not witnessing an odd occurrence in a sales simulation. Rather, we were witnessing the reality of what most clients are experiencing every day when meeting online or in person with salespeople: lackluster interactions and disappointing results. Surprisingly average to strikingly different. As we debriefed the meetings with client executives, a surprising theme emerged. Clients entered every sales meeting hoping against hope to see something distinct and relevant, whether in the message, thought leadership, the way the salesperson asked questions, the dialogue, or the solutions. But the vast majority of salespeople they encountered were simply indistinguishable. This phenomenon was validated in additional research with Primary Intelligence, where we analyzed the results of surveys with more than 14,500 B2B decision makers. Buyers saw no difference between vendors 42% of the time. We began calling this phenomenon the surprisingly average. Consider that as sales professionals, regardless of the industry, we're working with similar technology, approaches, people, and methodologies. In fact, most of us are solving similar problems with similarly long lists of client references and claims on the same outcomes. Again, we appear to be remarkably similar, therefore surprisingly average. But clients make decisions based on differences, not similarities. By the nature of the sales process, the client will expect some common ground between vendors. And we do often have to check off certain criteria, perhaps in our response to a request for proposal, an RFP. But in the final analysis, the differences between options make the biggest impact when it comes to decision-making. Where it's not good enough just to be different, the salesperson must demonstrate differences that matter to the client. Appearing in contrast to their competitors isn't news to sales professionals. They know they need to create this contrast, but they struggle to define contrast in a way that helps clients act on it. Because the client executives in our simulations had a vested interest in helping the salespeople get better, we were able to work with them to investigate what did and didn't work and the reasons why. We spent hundreds of hours with the client executives discussing, debating, testing, and learning together how salespeople could become strikingly different. Through our research and client work, we hit upon the simple formula for achieving compelling contrast that our client Mark and thousands of salespeople are successfully using to stand out. Relevant plus distinct plus memorable, or RDM, equals strikingly different. Relevant, focusing on what matters most to the client. Distinct, showing something that is different and better. Memorable, make it sticky, easy to share, and hard to forget. Seeing the world through the RDM lens will change how you see yourself, your clients, and every sales opportunity. RDM is brought to life in the six skills described next. The first four skills will help you connect and engage with your clients by exploring provocative ideas, experience, and future possibilities. The goal is to build a strikingly different message house that contains all your client messages under one roof. The foundation of the house is RDM. The roof is your main message, and your key supporting messages are the structural beams in between. Skill one is about how to capture the client's attention with a verbal billboard in any setting at any time. It is your core message for the client. Skill two is about how to create excitement with brief verbal or written movie trailers to get meetings, start meetings or proposals, and end meetings with increasing momentum. Skill three is about how to build confidence with flashbacks, i.e. success stories, where you've helped other clients, and a flash forward, where you help your current client see a clear path to go from where they are now to a different and better future. Skill four is about how to become essential with why us differentiators. Here you highlight unique differences and help the client see why those differences matter. The last two skills do not appear in the message house. These skills will help you partner with your client to validate and co-create the messages of the house so it eventually looks like, feels like, and becomes their house. When that happens, you and the client win together. Skill five is about how to get curious and find the gaps in the message house. Skill six is about how to navigate traffic lights, close the gaps, and complete the house. We'll discuss how all six skills come together through a sample middle stage discussion in the chapter titled Pulling It All Together. You'll notice that throughout the book, we discuss how to apply these skills in online sales interactions. But if you'd like more details, we've included an appendix at the end of this book on how to conduct winning sales interactions online and through video conferencing platforms. Whether you've just started on your sales career or you're at the top of your game, we're confident the formula and skills in this book will help you dramatically change your client interactions and results online and in person. They will help you go from just one in the crowd to consistently standing out as the different and better choice. We invite you to dive in, give it your best, and work hard to become strikingly different. It will be well worth your time.
Part 1.
connect and engage. Skill 1, capture attention with verbal billboards. Recall our Asia-Pacific-based client Mark in the introduction, who used a strikingly different RDM formula and skills to win a $16 million contract. In the first step of that process, Mark and his team captured the client's attention quickly and kept it with the following billboard, shared verbally and in writing, that had key messages in client-relevant language. Main headline: empower client IT as an indispensable, leading-edge strategic partner to the business. 1. Improve business process compliance massively from present levels to greater than 98% from day zero, thereby maximizing the business case benefits. 2. Accelerate client from the current state to a new technology-enabled proactive growth engine within the first 12 months. And 3. Move from a manual, high-incident volume support service to a proactive, hyper-automated service from day zero, where the best ticket in the world is the one that does not exist. After observing nearly 1,700 sales simulations, we found, as Mark did, the best way to grab and keep a client's attention is to use a well-crafted billboard. The billboard metaphor came from a client executive after sitting through a series of sales meetings where the salespeople droned on and on about themselves, their solution, their approach, and never got to the point. Their messages were not concise, not clear, and not focused on the client. In one particularly frustrating meeting, the client said, "Okay, let's get to the point. What do you want me to know? Sum it up. Give it to me in a billboard." We loved that idea and ran with it. What's fun about real billboards is their whole purpose is to grab your attention for a split second and compel you to remember something valuable about the product. The advertising industry has mastered communicating value quickly. After all, when you only have a split second of someone's attention, your message has to be simple and straightforward. We were convinced that salespeople could learn a lot from billboards about concision and delivering an enticing message in seconds. We began testing various forms of sales billboards in the simulations and with numerous clients in the field for several years until we came up with the simple pattern described next that is now used by thousands of successful salespeople around the world. Capture attention with sales billboards. In a sales context, a billboard is your core message for the client. It consists of a highly captivating main headline and 3 subheadlines that entice your client to keep listening. The themes carry through to all the other messages in the strikingly different message house. Can a few headlines really do that much? Absolutely. In fact, they have to. When our clients have decisions to make, challenges to overcome, and business strategies to execute, they don't want to be bogged down and held up. With planning and preparation, you can offer something to the client that has enough merit to stop them and entice them to listen. Once they've listened, they may want to share their perspective, and if that goes well, they may want to have a dialogue. There is plenty of time for sincere and active listening once the client's engaged and the discussion moves forward, but only if your first few words hit the mark. Let us be clear on this point. Clients do not want the precious first minutes of a meeting to be a fishing expedition. If you asked for the meeting, go in with something prepared and intriguing for the client to consider, and present it quickly. The time for exploration and validation is later in the conversation. We'll discuss an effective way to do this in Skill 5. 2 reasons sales billboards work. 1. Billboards are concise. Humans have short attention spans, as brief as 8 seconds, according to a Microsoft study. Billboards communicate an intriguing, client-focused message in just a few seconds. And 2, billboards are focused on client outcomes, not salesperson solutions. Clients want to see and hear a message that is crisp, sharp, and focused on them. They don't want a rambling message focused on a salesperson's company or solution. Follow the pattern of an effective sales billboard. 1. Think and speak in headlines. 2. Link to the client's goals and issues. And 3. Show from to client outcomes. Thinking and speaking in headlines will help you be concise. Linking to the client's goals and issues will help you be relevant, focusing on what matters most to the client. Showing from to client outcomes will help you be distinct by contrasting where the client is today with where the client could be tomorrow. We recommend using from to statements as often as possible to bring contrast to our ideas and ourselves as sellers. There is another compelling benefit of showing from to client outcomes. The human mind creates drama and intrigue more powerfully than anything we could say. When we associate from to outcomes with related symptoms and emotions, clients paint a vivid image in their mind of the current state contrasted with the promised future state, depending on the effectiveness of our words. They feel something rather than just understand what we are saying. And in the process, the client's motivation to explore possibilities with us increases significantly. What a sales billboard is not. A sales billboard is not a lengthy, rambling list of facts, data, and bullet points focused on you, your organization, and your solutions. You've heard the phrase, a picture is worth a thousand words. And many people have the picture, a slide deck and beautiful sales materials, but then they still share the thousand words as well. We have to stop this habit. It's painful for our clients. Billboards help us avoid this trap. Creating effective headlines. Headlines are the heart of a great sales billboard. Here are several real-world examples contrasting surprisingly average with strikingly different headlines from some of our clients. Company, data center company, surprisingly average headline. Provision, dedicated connectivity, and hyper-converged infrastructure faster. Strikingly different headline. Deploy new infrastructure in hours and days, not weeks and months. Company, truck driver recruiting company. Surprisingly average headline. We have flexible driving schedules. Strikingly different headline. From unpredictable schedules to being home when you want to be. Company, professional services. Surprisingly average headline. Streamline your maintenance ticket process. Strikingly different headline. Go from solving maintenance tickets to avoiding tickets. Company, healthcare services provider. Surprisingly average headline. We will improve your members' health outcomes. Strikingly different headline. You will lower costs by up to 11% and realize better health outcomes at the same time. Company, farming cooperative. Surprisingly average headline. Close the books much faster than you're already doing. Strikingly different headline. Go from the stress and frustration of closing the books in 6 weeks to the relief and satisfaction of closing them in 5 days. Consider the last headline. Notice the contrast between the surprisingly average headline, close the books much faster than you're already doing, and the outcomes, symptoms, and emotions in the strikingly different headline. Go from the stress and frustration of closing the books in 6 weeks to the relief and satisfaction of closing them in 5 days. How would you come up with these words? Imagine that through either early conversation with the client or a judicious assumption, you know the company's executives are demanding the numbers as close to period end as possible. Bankers need the numbers sooner to satisfy loan covenants. Salespeople's commissions are late when the sales numbers aren't validated until the books are closed. Everyone is demanding the financial team get the books closed faster with no errors. But the current disconnected systems and processes make that impossible. What would the financial team likely be feeling? Probably stressed, pressured, overwhelmed, frustrated, and resentful. How would they feel if they could close the books in just 5 days? Likely relieved, valued, and satisfied. Using the client's description of symptoms and/or emotions, coupled with the dramatic outcome of moving from 6 weeks to 5 days to close the books, transforms the headline from boring into something that stands out and causes the client to feel something and then do something. How to build a compelling sales billboard. Follow this writing process to quickly create a compelling sales billboard that contains your core message for the client. 1. Start by capturing key themes about the current state and desired future state at the client. 2. Boil your key themes down and turn them into 3 compelling from-to subheadlines. And 3. Now, step back and look at all 3 from-to subheadlines and write a persuasive one-sentence from-to main headline that captures the big idea for your client. Make sure it will create intrigue and cause someone to want to listen to the rest of your message. Don't worry about being too clever when crafting your billboard. Be honest and reflect the essence and motivating idea of your story. But watch out. After helping hundreds of salespeople create compelling billboards, we've learned that salespeople can almost always create their from-to subheadlines faster and easier than they can figure out their main headline. So it's usually not a good idea to try to come up with your main headline before you've created 3 subheadlines. Expect it to be an iterative process where you start with key themes, craft subheadlines, then write your main headline. Billboard builder example. Let's walk through a real-life example of how to follow the process to build a great sales billboard. We recently met Matthew in a live online, strikingly different work session we ran for his employer, a leading consulting company. Matthew is an executive who specializes in marketing operations. He needed to build a sales billboard to use with a marketing executive at Walmart. Here is the process he followed from start to finish. With some coaching from us, this took Matthew about 20 to 30 minutes. We noticed Matthew was listening intently as we described the content.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.